She's training 9 on 10 on a hard day, 6 or 7 on 10 on an easy day. So for all intents and purposes, her easy day, harder than most people's hard day. Wonder why she looks the way she does. Coach Greg, in today's video, we're talking about how Natasha Ocean built muscle, lost fat at the same time. After being injured for a year, she hurt her back. She had to stop training for a year. She has an excellent channel, amazing scientific information, and we're going to go over a video where she shares just how exactly did she get back into it. A lot of you might not have been injured, but you might have taken time off due to the COVID and you just weren't motivated. We're going to show you what to do, both training and diet. How can you get back into the gym and gain muscle, lose fat at the same time?
Before my injury, for a couple of years before, like, I've always hovered around 60 kilos. And I don't have a scale at home, but they have one at the gym. So I was like, let's just have a look. And I was like 66 kilos.
And the first thing I noticed in watching the video was she didn't lose all her strength and muscle all of a sudden. The strength, it slowly went away, and the weight, it crept up. There's no morning she woke up and said, I'm overweight now. There was no day like that. However, over the course of the year, she gained 6 kilograms. It doesn't sound like much, but it's 10% of her body weight. Coupled with the fact that she lost muscle, it ends up being a lot. You do look a lot different. I'm not saying that she doesn't look good. She always looks good. Even without training, she has amazing genetics. She just happens to look good. But in comparison, her fitness level went down, her cardio, her strength, the ability to do push-ups, squat, everything wasn't as good as before. And of course, she's highly motivated. She wants to get it back. So please don't make the mistake of joining the gym on the first day and thinking you can do everything. Slow and steady progressive overload. Start with things you can realistically stick to. It wouldn't make sense to train 6 days a week on day one. Start with something manageable, 3 days a week.
I basically just wanted to rebuild everything, and this is what I've been doing in the last 3 months in the gym and with my diet, and just get back to training like more sustainably and more regularly.
Don't expect to be able to do what you once did. There's no way you're gonna be able to do it. If you used to train hard for an hour, you probably won't get through the first 30 minutes. And if you don't want to feel like you got run over by a truck, go easy. Just start with warm-up weights. Don't go harder than last time. Start easy. Just show up. Drive to the gym, show up, and hopefully you make it through your workout. You don't have to perform optimally on day one. Day one, it's just about showing up.
I honestly feel really amazing now. Like, I feel energized. I feel like I'm getting back to myself. I'm not all the way there, but I'm really close.
And one great thing about coming back after a layoff is muscle memory does in fact exist. She wasn't training for 14 months, but in 3 months, she's almost back to where she was. That's great news. So if you haven't actually been to the gym in a year, you can get back to the gym and you will be back to your former self before you know it.
And then once I felt comfortable with 3 days a week where I was kind of looking forward to my next session, I felt like I was recovering properly, then I was like, okay, let's step this up.
And so progressive overload. You take your time going more often to the gym. She started going to the gym 3 days a week. After a while, she worked her way up to 3.5 days a week. That means every other day. You don't even need to go from 3 days a week to 4. 3 days a week to 3.5 days a week to 4 days a week, 4.5 days a week, 5 days a week. Take your time. Whether it's weeks, months, maybe even years, take your time and only bite what you can chew.
My goal here is to kind of do everything all at once. And I don't want to be like the most shredded person in the world. I don't want to be the strongest person in the world. I just want to be really well-rounded.
So she's rather unique in her goals. She wants to be good at everything. She wants to be strong. She wants to have muscle endurance. She wants to be athletic. She wants to be good at everything. Cardio, strength, muscle endurance, all of it. So her training, it's a little bit different than I would recommend to the average person, but this is what she does. She does some sets, very low reps, 3 to 5 reps, trying to get really strong. She does some sets, higher reps, time under tension, focusing on hypertrophy, building muscle. She also does explosive movements, trying to be more athletic. Couple that together, that is one intense workout. But remember, This is a high-level athlete with amazing genetics. You may or may not be able to copy someone as advanced as this. Although she's only back to the gym for 3 months, her training style, it's harder than probably 95 to 99% of people.
Sometimes my rest time will be like 150 seconds. So we're doing like a 1-to-5 work rest ratio because I'm really trying to prioritize resting properly.
So depending if she's training for strength, muscular endurance, cardio, she varies her rest from 30 seconds to as much as 4 minutes. 4 minutes if she's really trying to focus on strength. She's doing sets of 3 to 6, focusing on strength, she's resting 2 to 4 minutes. But if she's doing explosive training or focusing on just muscular endurance, hypertrophy, she can lower that rest time to as little as 30 seconds.
And with this, over time, it's really about progressively overloading. So after like a week or two, I'm trying to increase the weight each time so that I keep getting stronger and stronger and stronger.
And obviously, it goes without saying, think of progressive overload. Train harder than last time. Does that ring a bell? After a couple weeks, you get used to that weight. It gets easier. It's time to up the weight. Or alternatively, you could in fact go for more reps, slow down the eccentric motion, pause more, use better mind-muscle contention. What? Mind-muscle connection. The choice is yours, but make sure you're progressively overloading.
Once I've picked one main move for those heavy sets, I'll then pick one or two explosive moves targeting the same muscles and I'll superset into them, decreasing the weight each time.
And think she's not training hard? She's doing drop sets and supersets. Talk about training to failure. She's going to failure and beyond. She's only been at the gym again for 3 months. Remember, not everyone has this kind of genetics, and she does have an extreme background in fitness. If you're a beginner, if you've taken a time off of the gym for a year or more, maybe ease off on that. Progressive overload, you'll know if you can do it. If you're really sore, not recovering, you're going too hard. Feeling good, getting stronger? Well, try training harder.
So it does take about 25 minutes. It does form like a really big chunk of my workout. And honestly, like if there's one time in your life where you're gonna need an exquisite playlist, this moment is it.
And she brings up a good point about having a good playlist. You can listen to music and it can motivate you to train harder. But you don't need this music, the best song, for your warm-up. So if you really want to use music to perform optimally, save your favorite songs, the best tracks, for when you need to train super hard. When I'm in a bike race on Zwift, I literally am fast-forwarding songs until I get to my favorite song. That big hill's coming up, that sprint at the end, I want my favorite song. I need the song. It depends day to day which song that is, but I need a really highly motivational song to motivate me to go harder than last time. I look up at the sign facing me, train harder than last time, and I do it. I listen to the song, my favorite songs, and I push harder than ever before.
My rate of perceived exertion, which is how hard I feel I'm working, is about a 9 out of 10. And in the other 50% of my sessions, I'll intentionally go at a lower intensity.
And listen, even for this high-level athlete, she doesn't go hard like this all the time. One day, she's going balls to the wall. Or all out, hard, RP 9 or more. She's going as hard as she technically can on that given day. The other day, she's holding back a little bit, maybe training at a 6 or 7 on a scale of 1 to 10. The other day was a 9 and 10 or more. Most people who go to the gym, they're training about a 5 on 10 every day. They're half-assing their workout on a daily basis. She's training 9 on 10 on a hard day, 6 or 7 on 10 on an easy day. So for all intents and purposes, her easy day, harder than most people's hard day. Wonder why she looks the way she does. And I do apply this to my own training. I can't go all out crazy hard on the bike every single day. So for example, one day, a race for an hour, and it feels like death. I can't believe I pushed myself that hard. I'd be like, I could never do that ever again. The next day I'm going for a bike ride. I'm not trying to go and break my PR again the day after when I'm sore tired. I just ride. I might ride at a heart rate of 135, 140. On race day, 150 to 185. Big difference. So vary the intensity. Some days you can go really hard. Other days you need to back off a little bit. You'll know based on how you feel.
I feel like tracking progress is really helpful, but I'll never compare two measurements less than 1 month apart because the progress curve is never just a straight line.
And I do think this is a great tip. Don't track your progress and compare every single day. You're not going to get stronger every single day in the gym. You're not going to get stronger every day you ride the bike. But from month to month, it should give you enough time to compare. So don't worry if you're a bit slower, a bit weaker on one given day. Look at the month-to-month progress. Are you better each month? A month ago, you could do 100 pounds for 10 reps. A month later, now it's 100 pounds for 11 reps. Can't expect to go up a rep every day, but maybe one rep per month.
The next part was my diet, because my diet really changed and it happened really slowly that I didn't even notice, like small things.
Now let's talk about diet, because she injured her back, couldn't train, but last I checked, she didn't chip a tooth, she didn't have surgery on her mouth, she could eat exactly the same way as she used to. She never made major changes overnight. She slowly got out of the way she used to eat and gradually started eating more takeout, making small changes. These small changes, an extra 100 calories here, 100 calories there, it adds up. 3,500 calories are required to add an additional 1 pound of fat. She gained 6 kilograms, 13 pounds. So clearly she had thousands and thousands of extra calories over the year. 100 calories here and there, adds up to 10 plus pounds of fat gain in a year. And on the same account, here's the good news. If you gained a bunch of weight and you want to lose it, it's easy. Small changes. Maybe you're eating 5 shitty meals a day. Have 4 shitty meals and 1 good one. It's going to make a difference. Just make small changes that you can handle, that you can live with, and you will slowly get back down to your previous weight.
Well, that now and again turns into 4, 5, 6 times a week. Our involvement with food was like zero. You could even say it was sub-zero.
Test your might. Test your might. Test your might.
Mortal Kombat!
Sub-zero.
Did you not think of that when she said sub-zero? Did not every single person think of the fighting character Sub-Zero from Mortal Kombat?
For my non-delivery meals, I made sure that the recipes I was picking would take no longer than 10 to 15 minutes to prep.
Absolutely. To me, making quick and easy recipes is ultra important. Anyone can eat a delicious meal that a chef prepared at a restaurant. But what about when you got to do it at home? If it's going to take you 30 minutes or an hour to prepare a healthy meal, you might be thinking, let's order in, get that pizza and burgers. Let's deliver it. But if you have healthy food in the fridge that you can eat like that, 5 minutes, 10 minutes to make, you're much more likely to stick to your healthy diet. So why not give my freaking cookbooks a try? I have meatless cookbooks, regular cookbooks, all kinds of cookbooks. If you're looking for low-calorie meals that are filling, voluminous, low calories, lots of protein to keep you full, that is where I come in handy. These cookbooks designed by me are exactly what the doctor ordered. You need to eat in a deficit to lose weight, and these cookbooks allow you to stay in that deficit without being hungry, starving all the time while eating delicious food.
My calories towards the end of that year where I was away from the gym definitely increased. I was in a healthy surplus. I'd estimate I was around 2,800 to 3,000 calories.
Think this woman doesn't have amazing genetics? 2,800 to 3,000 calories a day, not working out, only weighs 66 kilograms. Wouldn't that be nice? It's calories in, calories out. Luckily, she has the kind of genetics that burns a lot of calories. Her BMR is higher. Her NEAT, non-exercise activity thermogenesis, that's higher. Lucky her. If you're not so fortunate, you're not going to be able to eat 2,800 calories without becoming morbidly obese. But hey, everyone can lose weight. If you are in a deficit, you're going to lose weight. The cookbook's going to help you to do that while being full.
So the key switch was keeping the volume of food the same, because I never want to feel hungry. I always want to feel like I'm eating lots of food.
The key switch was making the volumes of foods the same. If you're full, more voluminous foods, low calorie dense foods, fruits and vegetables, things that are filling larger portions, you're not as hungry, you're not going to eat, you're not going to cheat. I don't know how many times I have to say it. So many people are going to disagree with me. The idiots, the morons, the ones that haven't tried the cookbook, the ones that think I'm a moron, that they don't think it actually works, they haven't seen the tens of thousands of people who bought the book, they think it works and comment, change their lives. They haven't seen it. Thousands of testimonials saying, change my life. Thousands, tens of thousands have bought the book. You think they're all wrong? You think they're all wrong. Over 96% said they recommend the book to other people. 96% of people. Think of it. What are the odds of that? You got ace-ace, you're going all in, you got an 89% chance of winning. With ace-ace. This is better. My cookbook is better than having pocket aces. Get the freaking cookbook. It's like having pocket aces and an ace up your sleeve. It's a cheat code. Cheat to win. So you can see, it's not really cheating. You're just taking foods that you love, making them lower in calories, more protein, more volume, more full. You get to eat more. Who doesn't want that? I'll tell you who. People who aren't very hungry. People who are already lean. People who don't need to lose weight. Don't get the friggin' cookbook. You're already there. If you're not, if you're overweight, struggling, hungry, a big eater, get the book. That's what it's for. You're trying to bulk, get fat, sumo wrestling, football, need to put on 50 pounds. You want to bulk and cut? Don't get the book. Well, except for the cutting part, but you get the point.
Volume eating is the real secret to losing fat without ever feeling deprived.
What she said.
And I'd say I'm not fully there, like I haven't fully rebuilt the fitness foundation that I want to, but I'd say I'm like 60 to 70% there.
And what I don't know is, how can she make an entire video being so positive and smiling the entire time? I couldn't do it. I guess I gotta tell it like it is. But I do find it interesting to watch this woman. She's very smart, intelligent. She knows what she's doing. Highly athletic, very knowledgeable, very scientific. So I highly encourage you follow her channel. She's back, her injury, it's over. She's back in the training. Go and check her out. Hope you learned something. Ending it here. GregDucette.com for coaching. Greg Doucette IB Pro. The bloops are over there. Harder than the last time supplements. You know you wanna get one of those. Also, cookbooks, so many of them. Go check those out, training books. You know, to train, coaching plans, me and my team. Click the bell button, subscribe to the channel, like, comment, help the algorithm, and until next time,
test your might.